Biblical Revelation 5 verse 13.
Which is in heaven and on earth and under the earth.
Of the kingdom of hell.
Hallelujah. So today's date is the 16th of July 2023. So I would like to share something which has been very biblical as well as unexpected for many who didn't believe in the word of prophecy. First of all, I want to make it clear that I am not a prophet. I am not God. I am not Jesus. I am not the Holy Spirit. Even though I can attest to the fact that the absoluteness is real, that my predecessor has spoken about the Lord Jesus Christ, I'm speaking about specifically in John 14 verse 17, whereby he spoke of the Spirit of truth, saying that he will come as another comforter. And while he's on the earth among the people, he will also literally be inside of the people. So you know what you are feeling 24/7. So I am Aaron. So I would like to share something. I made a project, actually a song, and I was speaking about the universe making sound. Actually, I use it in the formation of singing, because you know that the waves of the ocean has a unique sound from the thundering of the heaven. All these are literally praising my supreme self. And in explaining this fact, I would like to read two biblical passages in the Holy Bible confirming the truth. Because 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 21 states, prove all things and hold fast to that which is good. So hear what it says right here. So before I say this, I just want to make certain that you have heard the song, and you should see an image which I have as the dragon. Many persons in Christendom have a phobia when we hear of the word dragon. We have never seen where the dragon has been approved, because we only learn from the shallow side of the gospel. And I want you to understand that in the heaven there are beasts, plural. However, in the shallow part of the gospel, we consider the beast as evil. Well, the Bible said, prove all things. In the book of Revelation, the beast is there worshiping God. In fact, the beast worship God the best, because the Bible said that the creature sees not day and night, giving glory to God. Just a moment. So Revelation chapter 4 verse 8 says, "And the four beasts had each of them 6 wings about him, and they were full of eyes within, and they rest not day and night, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come." So I pause at verse 8 of Revelation 4. So these were righteous beasts. As I was saying, from a shorter part of the gospel, we only could have disregard for hearing the terminology beast. So just for you to understand, when I'm sharing the word, I go in depth so that you have a full view of the gospel. So regarding the dragon, let me show you a passage. You know, I'm talking to the audience who have over 7 billion people on the earth. You know, I remember in Ephesians 6, whereby in that epistle, my servant the Apostle Paul spoke about one God, the Father of all, who is above all and through you all, as well as in you all. So you see the in effect once more that my predecessor spoke about. So this being is really in you all. So he spoke in Psalm 148 regarding all of his creation, and surprisingly, the dragon is among his creation. He made the dragon. So as I said, from the shallow part of the gospel, we will disregard the word beast as well as disregard the word dragons, casting these things as evil. However, when we understand the gospel in its absoluteness, we discover that it is really a shallow understanding of knowing God. Now, this is what it says in biblical Psalm 148. In my Bible, the subtopic is, "All creation praises the Lord." Now, verse 1 says, I read from verse 1 until end. "Praise ye the Lord, praise ye the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights." Verse 2. "Praise ye him, all his angels. Praise ye him, all his hosts." Now verse 3. "Praise ye him, sun and moon. Praise him, all his stars of light." I pause at verse 3 before I continue. So in the song, I was saying that the universe praise him. So all of this, which I have just read in verse 3, is speaking about the universe elements. Now I go to verse 4. "Praise him, he heavens of heavens, and he waters that be above the heavens." Verse 5. "Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created." Note the word. "He commanded and they were created." Now verse 6. "He also established them forever and ever. He had made a decree which shall not pass." So, just want to speak something about verse 6. "He has also established them forever and ever. Can you imagine? So let's see the things in which he established forever and ever. This will surprise many people. We hate the dragon because from the shadow part of the gospel, the dragon will be destroyed, my friend. However, this passage is not showing such thing. Listen what it says in verse 6. I read once more before I read verse 7. He had also established them forever and ever. He had made a decree which shall not pass. Now verse 7. Praise the Lord from the earth, ye dragons and all deeps. Now I pause at verse 7. This is hell. I'm making this very clear, my friend. When you hear of all deeps, in the book of Revelation, there is a part that is called a bottomless pit, which is a deep. So when the Bible calls the word all deeps, this is also included, the bottomless pit, since it's among the deep, among the deeps rather. Now let me read verse 7 once more, because this is really hell. Praise the Lord from the earth, he dragons and all deeps. Now verse 8. Fire and hail, snow and vapor, stormy wind, fulfilling his word. Can you imagine the word fire? Many people who speak of the light doesn't like the word fire. However, the Bible says that even the fire fulfill his word. Now verse 9. Mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars. Verse 10. Listen now. Peace and all cattle, creeping things and flying fowl. Now I pause at verse 10. The Bible said peace. This is where many people have a phobia, hearing the word beast, especially in these last days, my friend. I'm just enlightening the whole world, as the Bible says that not only he will be among the people, he will be inside of the people. I'm speaking about, for example, let's say myself in all talking. This is the manifestation. In all people, fulfilling Ephesians 6 and Habakkuk 2, verse number 14, right, where it says that Habakkuk, the prophet of God, had foreseen a time when the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord. That fills the whole earth as the waters cover the sea. So we are in this time right now. We are in such time, even in that time which has been foretold. Now verse 11 says, before I go to verse 11, let me make mention of the flying fowl. So we also have a phobia seeing a bird flying, speaking, my friend. Many persons say that this is Babylon. As the Bible said, I beheld a mighty, glorious being descended from heaven. And lo, his glory filled the whole earth. Can you imagine such power filling the whole earth? A glory descended. For example, we know that even the passage in which the Bible said that the earth shall fill with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord, the synonymous for this being as well, since he filled the entire earth with his glory. It didn't make mention of his name. He could have the name of probably myself, because his name is not mentioned. However, he came from where? The glorious realm, which can be found in biblical revelation. I will be showing you this shortly. He could have any name. Now verse 11, actually verse 10, as I was talking about the flying fowl. So because of this last day prophecy that speak about Babylon is fallen, Babylon is fallen and it's become the habitation of devils and the hold of every unclean and hateful bird. Sometimes we hear the word flying fowl, we only think of something evil because of the last days seeing a flying fowl manifesting. However, even these things, praise the Lord, as it says in the subtopic of biblical Psalm 48, all creation praises the Lord. Alright, so let's go now. Verse number 11 says, kings of the earth and all people, princes and all judges of the earth. Now let me explain verse 11. Sometimes we only think that only when a king is righteous, he's used by God. Well, not in all circumstances. Because in the book of Revelation, the Bible that spoke about the beast that come from the sea, having 10 heads, actually, let me see, having 7 heads, right? And 10 horns. So, the 7 heads are 7 mountains, right? The 7 heads are, see, this is how the spiritual warfare comes in. When I'm explaining the word of God, you see, if you are not being persecuted when you're sharing the word, is because your word is no offense for the evil powers that existed. So actually what it says, the beast that come from the sea, let me make this vividly in expression, is actually a ruling power, right, in which the woman sit upon. The Bible said that it's actually a dragon having 7 heads and 10 horns, and upon the horns 10 crowns. So the heads are the mountains, right, the 7 heads, and the horn which has the crown are 10 kings. So imagine here in verse 11 said the kings of the earth. Now let me pause right here, right, kings of the earth, and show you the express wording in Revelation. Just a quick review so to confirm this, because this is something very striking. The kings of the earth in plural, not the kings of the Lord, the kings of the earth. You have good and bad kings. So regarding the phobia for the kings, it says right here about the dragon, it says the beast of the sea. It says right here in Revelation 13, and I stood upon the sand of the sea and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having 7 heads and 10 horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, and upon the head the name of blasphemy. Consider the word, the name of blasphemy, written upon the head of the beast, right, who has 10 horns, which is literally the 10 kings that will manifest in the last days. Now let's show you in the word it written the kings of the earth, as I was reading, so to confirm. It says right here, it says in Revelation 17, subtopic, great harlot is destroyed. Actually, great harlot is described. Now verse 1 says, and there came one of the 7 angels which had the 7 vials and talked with me, saying unto me, come hither, I will show you the judgment of the great war that sitteth upon many waters. Now verse 2, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth
have made drunk with the wine of her fornication.
So I pause at verse 2. So this is something that the angel was described regarding the great harlot. As the subtopic says, great harlot is described. So what I want you to understand, it made mention the kings of the earth. Now let's look back on the passage in which we are going through, in Psalm 148. So in Psalm 148, remember the subtopic is all creation praises the Lord, and this Lord spelled with all capital letters, this is the Father. So in verse 11 said, kings of the earth and all people, princes and all judges of the earth. So you see kings in plural, and in the book of Revelation you see kings of the earth, just like in Psalm 148 verse 11, kings of the earth. So can you imagine, these kings were of the beast that came from the sea. So all creation praise him, and I'm going to show you in which they praise the Lord, even though they are of the beast, which is abominable, because the beast has the name of blasphemy. But let's show you where they actually honor God. Surprisingly, as I said, this is not a shallow message, so I go in full details by the persuasion of the Spirit of Truth that is in you 24/7. Now back to Revelation chapter 17 verse number 16, it says regarding the kings of the earth, which is of the beast, which has the name of blasphemy. Verse 16 says of Revelation 17, and the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these will hate the war, and will make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh, and burn her with fire. I pause at verse 16. So these who are of the same in which the woman sat upon shall destroy the same woman who sat upon their symbolism. So God turned this global power against itself. So the 10 kings shall destroy the woman, which is actually, if you understand the message, is the mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abomination of the earth, which is a religious system which is also political. So these 10 kings shall destroy her, and the Bible use metaphors in explaining shall make her desolate and naked, right, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire, which now giving you the exactness outside of the metaphors, because really these literally burned such world headquarter. Now listen what verse 17 says. This is where I say that all praise is the Lord, even the beast. Listen, verse 17 says, for God has put in their hearts to fulfill his will, and to agree, and to give their kingdom unto the beast, until the words of God shall be fulfilled. So I pause right here. Verse 17 said, it is God who put his word in the hearts of the kings, so to give their kingdom to the beast, so to fulfill his word. So these were the instrument of God in destroying the world. Surprisingly, even though the 10 kings were literally of the beast, which has the name of blasphemy. So you see, if you read Psalm 2 verse 4, the Bible said the Lord shall put the heathen in derision. Can you imagine God rise up a system which is blasphemous, and then choose from the system a set of people that he want to fulfill his will in destroying the system that he rise up. So is the righteousness of God being established through these 10 kings? Of course. This is just something that you will not hear from any preacher, my friend. Because when I teach, I am not of the regular. My glory that I told you about, which is of the Holy Spirit, a literal being that fills the whole earth that you can hear talking inside of you, is the teacher of teachers. The Bible said that when he comes, he shall lead you to all truth. So you see, God fulfills his will in the midst of darkness. Sometimes people think God only uses the light to overpower the darkness. Not in all circumstances. God also uses the darkness, the approved darkness, to overcome the disapproved darkness. So in this context, he used the approved darkness to overcome the disapproved darkness, which is not the same. So I just want you to understand, the Lord, according to Psalm 2 verse 4, shall put the heathen in derision. Derision means confusion. Sometimes we cannot fathom the way he works. So let me continue what I was saying right now. Back to Psalm 148. So verse, leaving from the part that said the kings of the earth. Now verse 12. Both young men and maidens, old men and children. Now verse 13. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is excellent. His glory is above the earth and heaven. Now verse 14. Complete the last verse. He also exalted the horn of his people, the praise of all his saints, even the children of Israel, a people near unto him. Praise ye the Lord. So, as I close in now this message, I put this as part of the book of Aaron, chapter 5. Just call it verse number 1 until 14. What I want you to understand is that I have a book which I've been writing for a while, has a very serious testimonies which literally take place in this time, especially in 2023, that can edify all that hears. Even revisited will continue to give edification above that you have already received inwardly from the 24/7 glory. What I want you to understand is that the song which I have made and put it as a project, after I've made this song, strange occurrences start happening around the world. People who are professional in the field of the galaxies, even the astrologers, even those that have sound wave technology, is hearing a lot of weird sound around the world, even singing and even in the sound of trumpet. And I have this footage so that you hear. After I made this song, I saw this on YouTube 3 days, actually in this month, July. So I want you to understand that the things that I share with you is not just from flesh. You are hearing from the spirit of truth. So when I speak, my word comes with power, with authority. The Bible said that when my predecessor was on earth, the Pharisees, which is a custom for all Jews, said they don't believe in him until he performs something in the heavens. They said, show us a sign in the heaven so that we believe in what you say that you are to us. Show us a sign in heaven. This passage is written in the Bible as well. So the Jews always ask for a sign to confirm the chosen for Israel, to confirm the chosen for the selected people. So I want you to understand that these signs, after I made the song about the universe sounding, and I said that I put it in the form of songs, because each creation has a unique sound. The bird doesn't sound like the lion, however the lion praise God. The sea doesn't sound like the thunder, however both praise God. The universe now, which is everything that you can think of, is making sound according to the song which you have made. And people has been recording this thing, so you'll hear what I said. And I said that September something is going to come on the radar that will catch attention. Something which I am telling you from the spirit of Leviathan. In the song you'll see Leviathan at the end is a dragon. In Job 41, God praised Leviathan before his servant Job. We know that God hates pride, however he made Leviathan an exception, saying that he is the king of pride. Can you imagine? Pride is the reason why Lucifer, for many Christians, was cast out of heaven. Yet there's a beast by the name Leviathan from the sea that God promotes, and even telling his servant Job about him, that he is the king of pride. God did not even reject his pride. God approved his pride. So you see, we cannot understand God in his fullness, my friend. Now you are hearing from the spirit of truth through me the fullness that fills all in all. Listen to the song and then you'll hear the testimony. Real thing happening in the world in July 2023, proving all things according to biblical epistle 1 Thessalonians 5:21. For I tell you only what is real through the spirit that is inside of you from me, that fills the whole universe and beyond. This one glorious spirit forever and ever.
Ladies and gentlemen, no time is left. Allow me to introduce to you, to everyone, of course, this new song which is bubbling hot right now. Is already overflowing. Now,
Has officially begun.
Riding the core. The spring of hell, fire and brimstone, volcano is erupting, the sea is roaring, this is the dimension of hell.
Now the volcano starts erupting.
This is the song of hell.
Hell yeah, the game tournament has officially begun.
Hold your breath, for something unusual is happening in Israel. People are perplexed and intrigued by signs of the rapture. What does this imply? Are we approaching the end times? And have you ever experienced something that seems so divine? Let us know so we can research it. So, what has been happening that has shocked people all over the world? Mysterious and enormous booms resonated over Israel's central area, leaving residents perplexed and looking for explanations. Initially, security services, including the army, struggled to explain the source of these odd sounds. Social media was swamped with reports of strong booms and shockwaves reported in regions like as Gush Dan, Tel Aviv, and Petah Tikva. The noises were heard as far north as Julis, which is 50 kilometers away. This couldn't be just a coincidence, right? Police and the IDF in Israel were baffled, unable to give a definite explanation for the blasts. This phenomenon is not exclusive to Israel. Similar unusual noises, dubbed sky trumpets or sky quakes, have been observed all around the world in recent years. People from all over the world, including the United States, Canada, Costa Rica, Russia, the Czech Republic, and Australia, have reported hearing low-frequency hums, trumpet-like or horn-like noises that appeared to come from the sky or beneath the earth. The novelty of these noises is what makes them extremely unsettling. Most of them have never been heard before, adding to the mystery. They have an unsettling tone to them, a moaning resonance and metallic vibrations that sound like musical instruments. Some report hearing unclear voices mixed in with puzzling noises. Could these noises be a precursor to something bigger? Is it an indication of the end times or the final call? With references to biblical prophecies that mention trumpets, let us examine what trumpets are like when they come, and whether these unsettling and mysterious noises are the ultimate portent of the end times. The trumpet sounds have regularly been described as a sign of the end of times. The Book of Revelation describes a series of key events that are linked to seven trumpets, each of which is heard by an angel. These trumpets foretell of terrible events shown to John of Patmos during his mystical experience. The sound of the trumpets in apocalyptic stories follow the breaking of the seventh seal, which protects a deep document held by the divine figure on the throne. These trumpets, known as salpigyx, salpinkes in Greek, were ancient bronze instruments with thin, straight shapes, bone mouthpieces, and bells. They look different from current trumpets. The last three trumpets are sometimes referred to as the woe trumpets, emphasizing their importance and the unpleasant character of the events they foretell. Within the framework of the biblical story, these trumpet blasts have significant symbolic resonance, adding to the profound character of the disclosures depicted in the Book of Revelation. After the Israelites left Egypt, God told Moses to make two silver trumpets known as chazan, Numbers 10, 2. These trumpets were not the same as the classic shofar, which was constructed of ram's horn and was used for religious purposes by the ancient Hebrews. Are you aware of the meaning of the trumpet blows? Let's dive deeper into the meaning of each of the blows, so we know what to expect when it happens. The first trumpet blow triggered a catastrophic event. Hail and fire mingled with blood showered down on the earth, destroying one-third of all trees and green grass. Revelation 8, 7. Following the first trumpet, the second trumpet caused a further disaster. An enormous flaming mountain fell into the sea, turning one-third of the water red. This calamity annihilated one-third of all marine life and ships. Revelation 8, 8, 9. Wormwood, a star, fell from the sky with the sound of the third trumpet. This star polluted a third of the world's freshwater supplies, such as rivers and springs, destroying many from the bitterness of the tainted water. Revelation 8, 10, 11. Some have drawn parallels between this occurrence and the Chernobyl nuclear accident, as the word wormwood has a similar connotation. The fourth trumpet signaled the arrival of darkness. The sun, moon, and stars were destroyed, resulting in full darkness for a third of the day and night. Revelation 8:12. The fifth, sixth, and seventh trumpets were the last to sound before the three sorrows. The fifth trumpet signaled the start of the first misery. An angel appeared and proclaimed three times, "Woe, woe, woe to those who dwell on the earth because of the remaining blasts of the trumpet of the three angels who are about to sound." Revelation 8:13. A personified star descended from heaven, unlocking the bottomless pit. Smoke rose, darkening the air and covering the sun. Locusts were discharged because of the smoke. These were not typical locusts. They featured scorpion-like traits, including scorpion-like tails. They were told to punish anyone who did not have God's seal on their foreheads, but not to murder anybody during the 5 months of suffering. Revelation 9:1-12. Some historians believe that the scorpion-tailed locusts signified distinct historical occurrences, according to a preterist interpretation. According to one interpretation, they represent the invasion of the Goths and other barbarous tribes who interrupted the Roman Empire during Decius's rule. Another theory holds that the locusts represent Jewish heretics who repudiated Christ, such as Theodotus, Praxius, Noetus, Paul of Samosata, Sibelius, and Arius. Revelation 9:3-11. After the fifth trumpet, the sixth, the second sorrow, sounded. Four angels emerged from the Euphrates River, commanding an army of 200 million mounted warriors. From their mouths, these horsemen spewed plagues of fire, smoke, and brimstone. The horses they rode had lion heads and snake tails. A third of humanity was slaughtered by their plagues. Revelation 9:13, 19. Finally, the third and last misery was marked by the seventh trumpet. As it was heard, great voices in heaven said, "The kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Messiah, and he will reign forever and ever." Revelation 11:15. The sound of this trumpet heralded the completion of God's plan and the foundation of his eternal reign. The first six trumpets act as a wake-up call to sinners and a summons to repentance in Christian eschatology. Each trumpet blast brings a more devastating pandemic than the one before it. The trumpet indicates that an urgent announcement or warning is on its way. The seventh trumpet, on the other hand, does not herald a plague. Its mission is to glorify God and proclaim his kingdom, Revelation 16:17. According to the preterist viewpoint, these trumpet blasts were battle signals against the apostate Israel of the period. They are said to be related to occurrences during the Jewish wars. The second trumpet, for example, symbolizes Rome as a metaphorical mountain that ravaged Galilee and filled the Sea of Galilee with blood and dead bodies. Some futurist Christian apologists argue that the big mountain blazing with fire and descending into the sea, Revelation 8:8, might be an impact event caused by a near-Earth asteroid. According to post-tribulationist Christians, the seventh trumpet described in 1 Corinthians 15:52 is the last trumpet, and it corresponds with events mentioned in Isaiah 27, 13, Matthew 24, 29, 31, and 1 Thessalonians 4:16. They feel that this confirms the belief that the rapture will take place after the tribulation period. The rapture, according to this viewpoint, occurs at the seventh trumpet blast. It is envisioned as a period when Jesus will rule and reign forever, rewarding those who are holy and punishing the wicked. The first woe, according to the Baha'i religion, corresponds to Muhammad's advent, the second to the Bab's advent, and the third to the advent of Baha'u'llah, the prophet founder of the Baha'i faith. The seventh angel, or trumpet, is thought to symbolize human beings endowed with divine qualities, heralding the arrival of Baha'u'llah, the promised Lord of hosts. Some musicologists relate Gustav Mahler's Second Symphony's conclusion with the seven trumpets. The symphony features four trumpets, a bass drum, cymbals, and an offstage triangle. Furthermore, some may ask if recent unusual sounds heard in the sky of Israel and other areas of the world are signals of the end times. While predicting such occurrences remains a mystery, it is crucial to recognize that other prophecies have still to be fulfilled before the day of judgment and the end. The unusual sounds are interesting, but they do not certainly foretell the start of the rapture or the end of the world. Or do they? It is strange for us to hear these sounds all over the world coming out of nowhere. Surely it must be something divine. It might not be the sign that the rapture is coming, but we should not take it lightly. Have you ever experienced something divine like this? And what are these weird sounds? Are they signs of the end of the world? What do you think of these unusual sounds heard across the world are? Leave a comment and subscribe for more rapture news.
Job chapter 41.
Canst thou draw out Leviathan with an hook, or his tongue with a cord which thou lettest down? Canst thou put a hook into his nose, or bore his jaw through with a thorn? Will he make many supplications unto thee? Will he speak soft words unto thee? Will he make a covenant with thee? Wilt thou take him for a servant forever? Wilt thou play with him as with a bird? Or wilt thou bind him for thy maidens? Shall the companions make a banquet of him? Shall they part him among the merchants? Canst thou fill his skin with barbed irons, or his head with fish spears? Lay thine hand upon him, remember the battle, do no more. Behold, the hope of him is in vain. Shall not one be cast down even at the sight of him? None is so fierce that dare stir him up. Who then is able to stand before me? Who hath prevented me that I should repay him? Whatsoever is under the whole heaven is mine. I will not conceal his parts, nor his power, nor his comely proportion. Who can discover the face of his garment, or who can come to him with his double bridle? Who can open the doors of his face? His teeth are terrible round about. His scales are his pride, shut up together as with a close seal. One is so near to another that no air can come between them. They are joined one to another. They stick together that they cannot be sundered. By his kneesings a light doth shine, and his eyes are like the eyelids of the morning. Out of his mouth go burning lamps, and sparks of fire leap out. Out of his nostrils goeth smoke, as out of a seething pot or cauldron. His breath kindleth coals, and a flame goeth out of his mouth. In his neck remaineth strength, and sorrow is turned into joy before him. The flakes of his flesh are joined together. They are firm in themselves, they cannot be moved. His heart is as firm as a stone, yea, as hard as a piece of the nether millstone. When he raiseth up himself, the mighty are afraid. By reason of breakings they purify themselves. The sword of him that layeth at him cannot hold, the spear, the dart, nor the habergeon. He esteemeth iron as straw, and brass as rotten wood. The arrow cannot make him flee. Sling stones are turned with him into stubble. Darts are counted as stubble. He laugheth at the shaking of a spear. Sharp stones are under him. He spreadeth sharp pointed things upon the mire. He maketh the deep to boil like a pot. He maketh the sea like a pot of ointment. He maketh a path to shine after him. One would think the deep to be hoary. Upon earth there is not his like who is made without fear. He beholdeth all high things. He is a king over all the children of pride.
Job chapter 41.
Canst thou draw out Leviathan with an hook, or his tongue with a cord which thou lettest down? Canst thou put a hook into his nose, or bore his jaw through with a thorn? Will he make many supplications unto thee? Will he speak soft words unto thee? Will he make a covenant with thee? Wilt thou take him for a servant forever? Wilt thou play with him as with a bird? Or wilt thou bind him for thy maidens? Shall the companions make a banquet of him? Shall they part him among the merchants? Canst thou fill his skin with barbed irons, or his head with fish spears? Lay thine hand upon him, remember the battle, do no more. Behold, the hope of him is in vain. Shall not one be cast down even at the sight of him? None is so fierce that dare stir him up. Who then is able to stand before me? Who hath prevented me that I should repay him? Whatsoever is under the whole heaven is mine. I will not conceal his parts, nor his power, nor his comely proportion. Who can discover the face of his garment, or who can come to him with his double bridle? Who can open the doors of his face? His teeth are terrible round about. His scales are his pride, shut up together as with a close seal. One is so near to another that no air can come between them. They are joined one to another. They stick together that they cannot be sundered. By his kneesings a light doth shine, and his eyes are like the eyelids of the morning. Out of his mouth go burning lamps, and sparks of fire leap out. Out of his nostrils goeth smoke, as out of a seething pot or cauldron. His breath kindleth coals, and a flame goeth out of his mouth. In his neck remaineth strength, and sorrow is turned into joy before him. The flakes of his flesh are joined together. They are firm in themselves, they cannot be moved. His heart is as firm as a stone, yea, as hard as a piece of the nether millstone. When he raiseth up himself, the mighty are afraid. By reason of breakings they purify themselves. The sword of him that layeth at him cannot hold, the spear, the dart, nor the habergeon. He esteemeth iron as straw, and brass as rotten wood. The arrow cannot make him flee. Sling stones are turned with him into stubble. Darts are counted as stubble. He laugheth at the shaking of a spear. Sharp stones are under him. He spreadeth sharp pointed things upon the mire. He maketh the deep to boil like a pot. He maketh the sea like a pot of ointment. He maketh a path to shine after him. one would think the deep to be hoary. Upon earth there is not his like who is made without fear. He beholdeth all high things. He is a king over all the children of pride.
He says, praise him, sun and moon, and praise him, all you shining stars. That's not just a poetic idea. That's really happening, because stars don't just shine. Stars also sing. Let me just show you a couple more stars. This one is called the Vela Pulsar, and it's magnificent. It's 1,000 light years away. It's a highly magnetized neutron star. Right. It simply means this star exploded into a supernova, and in the case of the Vela Pulsar, it collapsed back on itself in a magnetic entity, and as a pulsar, it began oscillating on its axis. This one oscillates 11 times a second on its axis. And as it is oscillating, you can see what's happening. It's shooting a radio frequency out of itself. When they aimed the radio telescopes at the Vela Pulsar, this is what they heard. And this is what this guy does 24/7, day and night, 365 days a year. This is what, from 1,000 light years away, the Vela Pulsar sounds like right now. This is it. Listen to this. Now, I don't know about you, but that blew me away. I'm thinking, wow, this is incredible. You're like, well, what does it mean? I don't know. Is that some kind of Morse code for something, or what does all that mean? I don't know what it means, but, and I don't want to, you know, go too crazy here, but maybe the Vela Pulsar got wind somehow innately of Psalm 148, verse 3, and since it says, praise him, sun and moon, and all you shining stars. We're a shining star. We should praise him. Well, how are we going to praise him? I know. Let's oscillate 11 times a second on our axis and see if we can send a radio signal into the universe that would join in the symphony of God's praise from all creation. It's singing. The stars are singing to him. I recently stumbled on 47 Tuck. It's a beautiful cluster of stars. We'll show you the picture of it here. There are 12 of these supergiant blue stars in there, but the things that are of interest to us tonight are these millisecond pulsars. And right now, tonight, while we're sitting in this room, the 16 recorded millisecond pulsars in 47 Tuck are making this sound right now. Beautiful. Who knew? You know, God has his own string section. Isn't that beautiful? And we just looked at 11 times a second pulsar and 16 millisecond pulsars, and you start seeing Psalm 48 come to life. But look down at verse 7. It says, praise the Lord from the earth, you great sea creatures in all deeps. The whale songs could sound like this right here. Take a listen. We don't know the expanse of the worship that is continually surrounding the throne of God. And our songs are great, but God isn't banking on our songs, because he is surrounded by a symphony that's bigger than our wildest dreams tonight. Stars sing and whales sing and the birds fly. And I just tried to imagine, what would it sound like if you could just for a second be God and hear what he hears? And I can't get us there tonight, but I came close. I had a friend who helped me with this little iPad program, and I'm not a DJ, but a little thing, just quickly, and I want you to see how this works. Now, this guy, we didn't look at his picture, he's PSR BO329-54. And he's only rotating 1.5 times per second, which is not all that much, but we need him in our little experiment we're going to do here, okay? And then we had the Vela Pulsar. You remember the Vela Pulsar, right? So that's that guy. But that's a little too fast for what we're trying to do, so we're going to slow that down, okay? So we're going to put the millisecond guys in there. The ones you just heard, here they come. Undoctored and unedited. Here they come. Asking what you're asking, because some people need it really clear, like, what are they singing? And we tried this, and you just got to know this is unedited. We just dropped this on, and this is what happened. This is what they might be singing. Just you and the whales.